key chapters like democratic rights, food security in India, federalism, citizenship and secularism have been dropped from school courses in the National Education Board, CBSE's bid to reduce the burden on students amid the coronavirus crisis. Now, the CBSE announced on Tuesday that the syllabus for 2020-2021 would be reduced by a third because of the extraordinary situation as the world fights the coronavirus pandemic. The board has revised the economics and political science courses for grades 9 to 12. There are chapters that have been completely deleted from the class 11 political science syllabus. These include the chapters on federalism, on citizenship, on nationalism and secularism. The ICSE had already also cut 25% of its syllabus, but what we're looking at now is a growing row as academics raise questions over why these particular chapters have been deleted. They raise questions about whether, in fact, a political agenda of sorts is being pushed over here and why these have in particular been singled out for deletion. It's interesting to take a look at the subjects. Now, democratic rights, as we said, also religion, gender, caste, chapters on these subjects have also been deleted, as have chapters on democracy and diversity, on popular struggles and movements, a chapter on challenges to democracy from the political science class 10 course has also been deleted. Now, a lot of people seem to question why this has been done. A chapter on federalism, which talks about states and their relation to the center, also gone. Chapters on citizenship, on nationalism, on secularism, all have been deleted for now. Himanshu joining us with the latest on that. Himanshu, what are the kind of questions that are being raised now over, well, presumably students, neither students nor teachers could deal with completing the whole curriculum. But is it the selection of chapters now that is raising this controversy? What are we hearing?
Well, I've spoken to two key people who were part of this project when these books were written and finalized. Suhas Palchikar, a Pune-based political scientist, one of the two co-authors of these books, which are now part of which will now be deleted as per the government decision. And he has made two, three very important comments, Suhas Palchikar. One, he said that every book that is written has a logic behind it. If you decide to delete a part or a section of a book, it amounts to a violence against the logic behind writing a particular book. And he's also said that there were many other ways in which burden could have been lowered on the students. Deleting chapters was, of course, not something that he agrees with. And he's also said that across the classes, the textbooks, if you see, there is a pattern. All mostly chapters related with diversity and democracy have been deleted. He said that diversity is the soul of any democracy. And so if you want to teach students about democracy, how can you take out elements related with diversity from these books? Now, Ankita, I've also spoken to the NCERT director, Krishan Kumar, who was between 2004 and 2010, the NCERT director for 6 long years. And he has commented also very strongly, saying that this right of students, school students, to read and understand history, democracy, diversity has been violated by these decisions to delete these portions. And his last point is also highlighted the fact that there are contradictions in the approach of the government. The government has said that chapters on federalism will be deleted, but the government wants to teach students about constitution. The chapters on social movement is being deleted, but you also want to teach history to students. Now, how can you teach history when history is created by social movements? How do you teach about constitution without teaching about federalism? So several questions are being raised about the decision to delete these chapters. It will be very important to see how government responds to these questions that are being raised. Ankita.
All right, Himanshu. Thanks very much indeed for raising those concerns that academics are now also highlighting about the chapters that have been deleted. Let's try and go across, if we can, to panelists who are joining us to discuss this in a little more detail, we have with us Dr. Ruchi Seth. She's the principal of Lotus Valley International School in Noida. Thank you very much indeed, Dr. Seth, for being with us. We also have on the phone line with us Professor Suhas Palshikar, who's currently the chief editor of the journal Studies in India Politics, but he's also been in the past chief advisor to the NCERT on political science textbooks, along with Yogendra Yadav. And Professor Palshikar, let me begin by asking you, you've actually raised several doubts about the chapters that have in fact been deleted from the syllabus. If you could take us through your concerns at this point, presumably 30% of the syllabus being deleted has been done in order to help both teachers and students who cannot deal with the caseload, with the course load at this time. But is it the selection of the chapters that is worrying you?
It's both method and the selection.
All right. Could you tell us a little more?
That is to say, yes, I understand that 30% syllabus needs to be reduced in view of the burden, but just dropping entire chapters doesn't do justice either to the students or to the syllabus. That's why I said that it is about the method. And then, as you said, the selection of the chapters, though understandably any selection would be problematic, there seems to be some logic hidden in the selection if you start right from the first textbook of class 9 till the 12th,
right,
which is that wherever the core of democracy is concerned, and these four or six textbooks deal with democracy and democratic politics together, mm-hmm. So wherever those cores are concerned, they seem to be chopped off. Now, this might be a coincidence. I don't know how this happened. This might be someone actually trying to toe a particular line without anyone dictating it. So I don't know how it was done. I was not consulted, but I'm sure many people would have been consulted. So I'm curious.
But Mr. Palshikar, Professor Palshikar, let me understand this. You were actually one of the people who advised the NCERT when these textbooks were actually being formulated. So a lot of these chapters, in fact, happened under your direct guidance and advice. Is that correct?
Right.
And would you then say that, having sort of, really overseen these textbooks, you feel that no political science course will actually, this particular course load will not do justice to the teaching of political science at this level?
No. What I'm saying is that this course load for this year, and I'm assuming that this is only for this year, there will have to be made some adjustments to be made. That's what I'm saying. But when we drafted the syllabus and when we wrote the textbooks, the idea was that a student should get a fair knowledge of how democracy functions comparatively, mm-hmm. not just in India, but elsewhere also, and how theorization of democracy happens.
Right. Professor Palshikar, we believe that chapters on federalism, for instance, have also been removed. Your thoughts on that?
As I said, federalism is not just, technically speaking, one of the core features of the Constitution, but it is the very heart of the way in which India's unity can survive and strengthen. Now, if you drop that from the teaching of either democracy or Indian Constitution, then you are surely hurting the very essence of the textbook. Each textbook has a logic. And when you reduce the burden, at least for 1 year temporarily, one has to be very cautious whether one is doing violence to that logic which informs the textbook. And probably I suspect that these cuts might actually cut at the root of that logic.
All right, Professor Palshikar, do stay with us because we're also being joined by Anurag Tripathi, Secretary of the CBSC, who can perhaps help explain why the decision was taken to drop these particular chapters. Anurag Tripathi, we have Professor Palshikar with us, who has advised the NCERT on the political science textbooks that were formulated, and he asks why these specific chapters, whether it comes to democratic rights or democracy and diversity, for that matter, gender, religion and caste, is this being done perhaps to toe a particular political line? What was the basis of selection for these chapters to be deleted?
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. ज्वाइन कराने के लिए, और मैं आपके चैनल के माध्यम से सारे पेरेंट्स को, टीचर्स को, बच्चों को अपनी बेस्ट विशेष देता हूं कि ये पैंडेमिक समय में पेशेंस रखें, और ये समय आज नहीं तो कल निकलेगा और हमारी एजुकेशन इंस्टीट्यूट्स वापस अपनी पुरानी स्थिति में आ सकेंगे। जहां तक आपके प्रश्न का सवाल है, मैं उत्तर देना चाहूंगा कि जो सिलेबस कम किया गया उसका मूल उद्देश्य है बच्चों को स्ट्रेस फ्री रखना, क्योंकि हम खुद देख रहे हैं कि अप्रैल में, मई में या इस समय भी क्लासेस नहीं चल पा रही हैं और ये थोड़ा समय और लग सकता है। तो बच्चे बोर्ड एग्जाम में 100% का टेंशन ना लें, इसलिए हम लोगों ने इसको रेशनलाइज करने का प्रयास किया, और इसके लिए एक एक्सपर्ट टीम रही है जिसमें टीचर्स रहे हैं, प्रिंसिपल्स रहे हैं, एक्सपर्ट्स रहे हैं, पेरेंट्स रहे हैं, थाउजेंड्स लोगों के सजेशन भी लिए गए हैं, और वो टीम एक निष्कर्ष पर पहुंची कि किस तरीके से कम करना है। तो मैं आपको बताना चाहूंगा कि इसमें चार पांच चीजों का ध्यान रखा गया। एक, कुछ ऐसे चैप्टर्स हैं जो सिमिलर टाइप के चैप्टर उस बुक में मिलते जुलते एक से ज्यादा थे, तो ऐसे चैप्टर्स, टॉपिक्स, कॉन्सेप्ट जो सिमिलर थे उनको कम करने का प्रयास किया गया। सबसे पहले तो आपको यह मानना है कि 30% कम करना ही था, क्योंकि क्लासेस कंप्लीट नहीं हो पा रही थी। अगर नहीं कम करेंगे तो बच्चों पर बर्डन जाएगा, पेरेंट पर बर्डन जाएगा, स्ट्रेस में आएंगे। तो पहले वो जॉयफुल रहें, टेंशन फ्री रहें, उसके बाद नेक्स्ट स्टेप आएगा लर्निंग का। अब आइए सेकंड स्टेप पे, अगर कम करना है तो किसको कम करें। तो हम लोगों ने जो प्लान किया, हमारे एक्सपर्ट ने जो एडवाइस किया, उसमें पहला ये था कि कुछ ऐसे चैप्टर या कॉन्सेप्ट जो रिपीट हो रहे हैं सिमिलर नेचर के, उनको कम कर दें। दूसरा, ऐसे चैप्टर जो अगले चैप्टर से कनेक्ट ना हो रहे हों, इंडिपेंडेंट हो, उनको कम करने का प्रयास किया, जिससे लर्निंग गैप कम ना हो, कॉन्सेप्ट उनके खराब ना हो। तीसरा, कुछ ऐसे टॉपिक और चैप्टर भी हमने कम किए हैं जो लीस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट है, कम इम्पॉर्टेंट है। कुछ ऐसे इम्पॉर्टेंट चैप्टर भी कम किए हैं जो हमें मालूम है कि बच्चे हायर क्लास में पढ़ लेंगे, या तो पहले पढ़ चुके हैं उससे रिलेटेड, या हायर ग्रेजुएशन के समय देख लेंगे, या नेक्स्ट क्लास में देख लेंगे। तो चार पांच चीजें तय की गई कि हम क्या तरीका अपनाएं। हालांकि हमें बहुत कष्ट हुआ उनको कट करने में, कम करने में, क्योंकि हमें भी मालूम है कि जो बच्चों के बुक है, सिलेबस है, कॉन्सेप्ट है, बड़ी मेहनत और रिसर्च के बाद बनता है, लेकिन ये पैंडेमिक के समय में सिवाय 30% कम करने के इससे बेहतर दूसरा उपाय नहीं था। दूसरा ये भी बताना चाहूंगा कि हम लोगों ने अपने स्कूल्स को, टीचर्स को एडवाइस किया है कि हमने रिड्यूस किया है, डिलीट नहीं किया है। रिड्यूस का मतलब यह है कि जो 30% रिड्यूस किया है उनको, कॉन्सेप्ट्स को बच्चों को अवेयर जरूर किया जाए, प्रोजेक्ट के थ्रू, एक्टिविटी के थ्रू, अलग अलग मोड्स में। हाँ, वो एग्जाम की टेस्टिंग में नहीं आएंगे, हम उनसे प्रश्न नहीं पूछेंगे, क्योंकि बच्चे तनाव मुक्त रहें, लेकिन हम ये जरूर उम्मीद करेंगे कि टीचर और पेरेंट्स उन चीजों को बच्चों को पढ़ा दें या समझा दें प्रोजेक्ट के थ्रू, जिससे गैप ना हो। तो मैं अपनी बात अगर समराइज करूं तो हमने 30% सिलेबस को रेशनलाइज किया है, प्रयास किया है कि वह चैप्टर घटें जो कॉन्सेप्ट्स रिपीट हो रहे हैं या डुअल हैं या आगे बच्चे पढ़ सकते हैं या इंडिपेंडेंट हैं। इसमें और कोई दूसरा उपाय नहीं था, और जहां तक ये बात है, बड़ा न्यूट्रल होकर के किया गया है, और कई हजार लोगों का सजेशन, टीम, रिसर्च फिर करके किया गया है, और जितनी जल्दी ये समस्या खत्म होगी वापस हम पढ़ाई के मुद्दे पर आ सकेंगे।
वी हर्ड योर एक्सप्लेनेशन प्रोफेसर पर्चिकर। वी हैव अनुराग त्रिपाठी, द सेक्रेटरी ऑफ द सीबीएसई, टेलिंग अस दैट दिस वाज डन टू रिड्यूस कोर्स लोड। एज वी नो, इट वाज डन विद कंसल्टेशंस ऑफ thousands of stakeholders, including teachers and principals of schools and other stakeholders. What the crux of what he is saying is that heads of schools and teachers must now ensure that the topics that have been reduced for the moment are also explained to students to the extent required in order to connect different topics. However, it's only that they will not be part of the topics for internal assessment or, for that matter, the year-end board examination. So it's not as though this will not be taught or explained, these concepts. Students will merely not be examined on them. Are you satisfied with this explanation, Professor Palshikar?
Okay, let me say in the first place that I entirely agree that whatever cuts the CBSE did, there would have been some displeasure, some controversy.
Right.
Number two, the point Anuragji is making, that these are not actually deleted but reduced, contradicts what the CBSE probably says on its website, because as far as I understood it, there is a clear mention that these are deleted. Now, a lay teacher or a lay student or a lay parent who will look at that circular would understand it as deletion. And deletion, if I understand the word correct, is deletion, which is dropping entirely from teaching learning. What he is now saying does make sense. And that is what I said initially, that the method is wrong.
Right.
That these topics are for self-study.
Yes.
That these topics are not probably for testing in an examination is an entirely different thing from saying that these topics are deleted. The third thing he is saying is that this is done in an unbiased manner. The question is not of only bias, but of an academic logic. You can get thousands of suggestions, of course, but finally, some committee has to sit and decide if there is an academic logic. Let's say, for example, instead of dropping an entire chapter on secularism, if only some parts were dropped and then said that, okay, these are the two sections which will still remain as important core of this chapter that you must study, then it would have made sense. And finally, class 9 and 10 are the foundations of the way in which students look at the social universe. They might not study political science later, remember. And therefore, dropping diversity-related topics from class 9 and 10 is probably far too detrimental to the building of a certain type of social universe that the Constitution aims at. And that is where my grudge would still remain.
All right. Let's go across to Dr. Ruchi Seth, who's been listening to all of this very patiently. Thank you very much, Dr. Seth. Now that you've heard both sides, as it were, as a principal, as an educator who will actually have to now ensure that this course load gets completed and that students have to appear for this examination, how do you view this entire controversy that we are now seeing play out over the chapters or topics that have been deleted?
Thank you, Ankita, for having me on your panel. And I think this reduction of the syllabus is very welcome, first of all. And I know that it's a very difficult task. It must have been difficult for CBSE to first take in all the stakeholders and then to make sense of all the various viewpoints that they must be getting. So I would just like to tell Mr. Tripathi that we understand that this is not an easy task. However, and also I'd like to say that it's been a long time that we've been waiting for this, and I'm so glad. It's not just the pandemic as such,
right,
but even before that, there was talk about scaling down the syllabus. So in a sense, the pandemic has pushed it. And while it's a welcome cut down of the syllabus, the fact is that we look at history and political science as creating citizens. And the content relates to how we can change mindsets, improve mindsets and attitudes to be able to make global citizens. And when we completely delete certain chapters like Making of a Global World or a chapter on secularism and, understanding through the historical perspective, and that's why we think it's important that the partition of India should also have been a part of the curriculum even now, despite the fact that we are short of time. But I think these are very important issues to ensure that, as Professor Palshikar had just mentioned, to create a social universe which is conducive to a better world ahead.
Right.
So for
right.
that, every child in the universe, when they become global
yes,
citizens,
yes,
they should be able to have the right attitudes and values.
But Dr. Seth, I think the question remains, as Mr. Tripathi points out, everyone would have had a problem with some deletion or the other. We're looking at a reduced time frame here. We're looking at lots of logistical problems. They had to cut something. Do you see necessarily
yes.
a political agenda in what has been deleted?
It's hard to say, actually. I mean, I'm not a student of history, so I won't get into the depth of it. But I think, yes, there is a certain... why did secularism, first of all, let's look at it. Why did it come into the first place through the 42nd Amendment? And now, why have we deleted it? That's a question that raises in our minds.
Okay,
and,
no doubt we're going to be talking about this
religion,
for some time.
These
I'm
are
afraid.
Issues that
yes.
we've been dealing with all
right.
this while. And
yes.
suddenly we find that it's completely wiped off. So those are questions that come up in our minds.
Mr. Tripathi, we hope those questions will continue to be taken up by the CBSE, and the feedback that you are receiving right now will be incorporated also in further amendments going ahead. But thank you very much for joining us on the show, Professor Palshikar. Thank you very much for your valuable inputs. We will take a quick break at this point. More coming up.